has spent so much of money. They have organized film festivals in the IFFI Goa International Film Festival. They had announced that they would even give out an award for best environmental film called the Vasudha Award. But of course, there were a lot of protests against that, and ultimately they withdrew it. But what we realized is that more and more of the traditional media filmmakers and all would end up being appropriated by big capital. Knowingly or unwittingly, but they would end up like that. So we realized that I also realized that I had to make myself irrelevant to the people's movements. The people's movements have to find a way to respond to these situations by on their own steam. They cannot rely on some filmmaker like me who will write a proposal to some funding agency, and it will take me 1 year to get my proposal passed, and by the time I can gather a crew and end up in the village and in 1 week wind up my shoot and come back, it doesn't really help the movement. So वहाँ से शुरू हुआ और ऐसे होते हो कि अभी there are about 15-20 people representing every movement from those movements who have their own cameras. These cameras have also been bought by their own money. They have saved their money and they have bought these cameras. We also didn't want to have this sort of a typical NGO style of operation where we doled out fancy things to people. So now we have a certain sort of mechanism to respond to the manipulations of the media and we don't have big satellites that we can straight away transmit whatever we shoot into your homes, but at least the internet has some advantages. Of course, the internet is mainly used for other things which are not so great, but it does have some good features. I think it's like a spillover of technology that we have to kind of subvert and use it. So that happened, and in that process we also saw that it has its own dangers as well. Like people in Niyamgiri and Kalinganagar who were shooting these things, they were targeted. The person who was doing it for us in Niyamgiri, he was ultimately bought off by the company. In Kalinganagar, he was Raghu Jamura, who was a neighbor of Comrade Dabur Kalindya. He was ultimately threatened and offered job and whatever. He did not totally sell out, but he had to, after a point of time, he did kind of become quiet. So we also realized that while we have been able to reach out and bring the truth out, it also exposes and makes people vulnerable within movements. So the internet and and also to answer about democracy now and the television channel, I don't know about that, but what is suddenly is possible is that is what we also do is that we produce these DVDs and we just distribute in the villages so that people can watch it in their homes, and that is the main thing to ताकि जो नियमगिरी में हो रहा है वो उसको के विरोध जो लड़ रहे हैं उनको पता चले, क्योंकि मीडिया तो इसके बारे में बोलेगा नहीं, और एनजीओस या फिल्म फंडिंग एजेंसीज नियमगिरी के लोगों के लिए फिल्म को फंड नहीं करेंगे. वो नियमगिरी के ऊपर जो फिल्म बनेगा वो यहाँ के ऑडियंस के लिए जरूर फंड करेंगे, लेकिन नियमगिरी के लोग क्या देखेंगे? जब एक माइनिंग कंपनी आता है तो माइनिंग से क्या होता है उनके लिए कोई तो फिल्म बनाए. इसलिए नियमगिरी में तो ये तो हमारा अनुभव भी हुआ कि मूवमेंट एक टाइम पे काफी थम गया था, क्योंकि फैक्ट्री बन गया था वो वेदांत का लांजीगढ़ में, खूब जबरदस्ती से उन्होंने किया था वो सब. और नियमगिरी के अंदर डोंगरिया कौन जो कम्युनिटी है उनको समझ में तो आ गया था कि ये बहुत बड़ा प्रॉब्लम कुछ है, लेकिन माइनिंग ऐसा पर्टिकुलरली क्या है वो उनको समझ में इतना नहीं आ रहा था, क्योंकि उनका समझ ज्यादा है कि जो उनके जंगल में कुछ 200 टाइप के मेडिसिनल प्लांट्स है उसके जो 1000 यूजर्स हैं उनके उनको वो सब ज्यादा समझ है, और माइनिंग से क्या होता है वो नहीं मालूम था. तो हम लोगों ने एक फिल्म बनाया जो वहाँ के लोग और मैं हम सब मिलके उन्हीं के भाषा में बनाया कि माइनिंग क्या होता है, और वो फिल्म हमने गाँव गाँव में दिखाया. वो फिल्म बहुत ही क्रूड है और उतना शायद एस्थेटिकली और मतलब देखने के लिए बोर भी लगे, बोरिंग लगे कि बहुत लंबी लंबा फिल्म है जिसमें कुछ एक वॉइस ओवर है बोलता जाता है बोलता जाता है, बट मोर और लेस इट सर्व्ड अ पर्पस एंड सो इट इज एसेंशियल टू रिमेंबर दैट this sort of cinema, this sort of films, this sort of material that is being produced has ultimately, it has to be of use to the people. 500 DVDs and distributed in 500 villages. And that I think is the way ahead for us, at least that's what we have been doing. And but of course, what I must also mention here that the biggest thing for us that in Orissa has been that we were only looking to reach out to people nearby, and whatever material or film was being was happening, it was like part of the campaign of the movement. It was not standalone films. But what happened with the arrival of Cinema of Resistance is that it totally changed, because we suddenly found space across the country to go to bring our films, and our work was considered as films by Cinema of Resistance. So everybody else is like, okay, this is not really films. So I think here the Cinema of Resistance experience got completed, from the where there is resistance and the cinema that was emerging out of it finally found a platform to, and again kind of subscribing to the same ideology. So that is definitely for us, I think maybe not democracy now, but Cinema of Resistance for sure. Yeah, I mean, thank you.